What's up, YouTube? We have a beautiful rain going on right now, and I just wanted to kind of show my guard when it's a little wet outside, you know. When there's a little rain coming on. When there's a wind blowing through here, it's just absolutely beautiful, guys. But we have some big melons in here, guys. Absolutely beautiful. Look at this size. It's a crimson sweet. It's absolutely huge. Got many jubilees. Much larger jubilee. Beautiful, guys. Look at this. Another jubilee. One, two, and then three jubilees. We got the Charleston. Super large Charleston. The pan starts here. The Charleston ends back here. Back here, looks like we have a cow sweep. But you know, I think I might call this one off because it's growing so slow compared to all the other melons. This one off, guys. Calling this one off, guys. It's growing slow compared to everything else. But there's another female bloom right here. So we have plenty of female blooms, guys. And I'll just hold on to this and use this for size comparisons. I only called it off because everything is basically a large melon at this point. So anything that's not large, it may not have been fully pollinated. But you can see size comparison to the Charleston. See if we can sit it on here. And this is size comparison to the Charleston. There's another Charleston right there. Charleston, then there's a super huge crimson sweet right here. And notice this in the camera, you can see the striping. It's behind those bushes. I won't go in there right now. Look at it compared to this Charleston. Charleston is highly prolific, guys. Small Charleston's right there. So there's a lot of melons. See, some crowns here. Okay, you can see the striping is different on them. Another jubilee. The large jubilee. Sweet. Now this is what I meant by it not being as large as the other melons. This is a kale sweet. This is a kale sweet. So the fact that it's nowhere near this size and it's been growing slow every day, I called it off. And I just didn't feel comfortable letting it sit on the vine too much longer because I had another melon that I had to call off also that wasn't growing too well. And I did a video on it 2 days ago maybe. This is compared to a Charleston. Just found another melon the other day, matter of fact. Let's see if I can spot it again. I've been noticing mushrooms coming up too, guys. All in my soil mix. So I wonder if it's highly nutritious. Add that to here. But here it is. I was like, where's my melon? This is another Charleston. I think it's a Charleston. must have been recently pollinated, so it is growing. The rate of speed that everything grows, I know if it's a healthy melon or not. Charleston, and I want you guys to take note. I have 12 mature vines. Although I have 12 mature vines, only two of them are Charleston gray. And if you notice, a majority of my melons are Charleston gray. So Charleston gray is a highly prolific melon, guys. If you're looking for something that's a high producer, I'm not too sure of its flavor yet, but it's definitely a high producer. And here we have a super large cow sweet. That's just standing up on its own. I discovered this one yesterday. Matter of fact, I discovered 3 melons yesterday. The other 2 are inside the bed. But they'll be hard to get to. Look at this. This is absolutely huge. Let me compare this cow sweet to the other one. And I was just wondering if his energy was going to this melon or not. So that's another reason why I want to call him off. See, the bottom is way down here, and I'm still not at the top yet. Okay, so yeah, so that's a huge cow sweet, guys. It's a huge cow sweet, and there's just many more. Ooh, and the bees are pollinating, so we're doing very well. See that? We're doing well. Although it's raining, it's still pollinating. So that's another benefit of the forest canopy. You can't expect a bee to pollinate in the rain, or can you? But you can when they're protected under the foliage of your plants. So that's my update for today, guys. I'll do another update when I enter the bed. It's raining right now, so I can't stay out here too long. But I'll do another update when I enter inside the bed. And I'll show you the other 2 melons that I found. There's some huge ones. Or the other 3 melons. There's some huge ones in there, guys. So I'm gonna cut this melon up and compost it and add it to the pile. Or add it to the planting of every other melon. Alright, guys. Get a final shot.